识别。I can do buttons. So, of time. Once upon a time, it granted us the sweet balm of forgetfulness and had the power to wash the past clean. Every grief, every sin, every insult. But not anymore. The never ending now that humanity drifts in, nothing is forgotten. Humanity has fallen outside of the flow of time and straight into a prison of eternity. It cries that the dead will never cease. Benil's guilt will never fade. This I have to wait on. Questy quest. What's this say? Warn and find a man with no name. I have no idea where that guy is. Got a use known for that one. I have to wait for that one. Oh, I did that. Did those. Ah! Did all of those. I see what? Oh, dreadnoughts, okay. Need 80 tattered leather? What the fuck? Okay. Yes, I gotta kill some of the shit I've been avoiding.
Just come back from prayer.
Good for you. Nurse station. What? Oh.
Don't get in my way.
I'm gonna stab you with an axe. And then kill you. Pew pew!
I hope you can make it.
Any more? That is more. Storm. No. Damn it. Mortar coils, okay. So I have to get the annoying thingies and the doggos.
You look like you have troubles. Something on your mind there?
Well, no, not really. Just, lost in my thoughts. Thinking about an old friend.
Oh?
He passed away, unfortunately, a while back.
I'm sorry.
Oh, by the way, my name is Armand. Would you have some time to spare? I have quite a story to tell about him.
Sure. Tell me about him.
He was a reporter. A firm believer that the pen was mightier than the sword. A do-gooder. Believed he could save people by exposing the evils and hypocrisies of society. Naive, maybe, but full of determination.
Being naive's better than having no ideals at all.
Agreed. At first, he was just a regular beat reporter for a local paper. His articles were mainly about the local stores and great discounts they were offering that week, you know. Little tidbits to help people out in their daily lives. As you can tell, nothing worthy of the front page. But one day, a great opportunity fell into his lap.
He got assigned a big story.
You're one step ahead of me. But that's enough storytelling for one day. The rest will have to wait for another time.
Bitch, you don't tell me a story and then fucking just go, yeah, you got a big story, and I'm not gonna tell you anything else.
I'd be happy to share the rest of my story.
Man, I have this great story, and I'm glad you did all this for me. But you know what? I'll tell you later.
You're like, I don't have time right now. I'm just fucking standing here, you son of a bitch.
Hey, slow down. What are you doing racing around the city like that?
I'll tell you, but only if you beat me, okay? The rule is simple. Keep up. Don't think you can beat me because I'm a kid.
Maybe I'm. No, I don't want to race.
Oh, I'll tell you where the finish line is eventually. Ready, set, go! The goal is the Forsaken Graveyard! No way!
Did you have breakfast? I don't even have to sprint.
I'm not gonna lose to a grown-up.
Fellow called Armand. Every day he comes out to stand on the street and does nothing but talk to himself.
It's sad that I had time to talk to that guy.
Thank you.
fine, it's dead.
This broadcast is brought to you by the Public Morals Office of the Order of Salvation. It is now noon. Please pray. Let us devote our working day to the glory of God.
Wow. Damn it.
Just you watch.
I already beat you, kid. I'm gonna beat you again.
Darn it! But I guess a loss is a loss.
You said you were gonna tell me what's going on if I won. You're gonna keep your word, aren't you?
It's nothing exciting or anything like that. It's just that the whole city seems so gloomy, don't you think? Everyone's so lifeless and boring. I thought this was a good way to add a little excitement. Show people how to have fun.
I won't say it was a bad idea, but weren't there other ways?
Maybe, but running's about the only thing I'm really great at.
Yeah, I have to admit, you're pretty fast, but not as fast as me.
Well, I'm happy if I helped you get your mind off things even for a little bit. See ya!
Lightning.
Ha! That's a perfect name for someone fast like you. I'll beat you next time, Lightning.
Wow. I got a couple hours before work. I got Tiki hooked on this again. Where I was even going before I ran into that kid. Oh right, I ran into this little fucker.
I know you're pure.
Yeah, go for it, dude. Can I talk to you now?
What is it? Something the matter?
Yes, actually. See this supply sphere? It's property of the Order. This is not the correct place for it at all.
That's strange. Do you think someone stole this from the Order's repository and left it here?
Yes, exactly. And it's not the first time it's happened. Stolen supply spheres are turning up all over. Of course, I have a good idea who the culprits are.
The children of Etro, maybe?
Exactly. It really is most exasperating, not to mention worrying. Sabotage.
Some parts of this game are spoopy.
Mark my words, the heretics are dangerous. Who knows how far they'll go?
You do know that the easiest way to find out what's inside would be to take a look?
Well, as a matter of fact, I'm waiting for someone to come and deal with it as we speak. Though seeing as you're already here, the Order would be most grateful if you helped out.
What do you want me to do exactly? Check all the spheres and see what's inside?
Yes, each and every one. They're locked, of course, but this passcode should open them. Use this.
Yeah, you can finally open that treasure.
After you've examined them all, come and talk to me.
What should I do with the contents?
If you've determined that there's no danger, you can keep whatever you find inside. Will that do as compensation? Oh, just don't forget to report back to me once you're done.
Okay, I will take 3 over fucking 13, okay? Gimme.
The victims of the children's rituals come back to haunt the area at night. I want to see it for myself, but I'm not stupid enough to walk around after dark.
A lot of strange rumors are going around. People are whispering about ghosts and ghouls. Of being haunted by dead girls. You don't believe them, do you?
I like to keep an open mind. If the stories are true, I'd like to help those people.
It's okay.
They died because of me.
As much as I hate to say this, you're not omnipotent. As the savior, you don't have the power to...
Shut up, Pope. And poof!
Expected as much.
Hi, Joey. Welcome, my dear. My dear. My dear.
Yeah, I know the extent of my own powers, Hope. But never say never.
A good seed hunter.
No, I don't have any more. Okay. You can come lay down, Joey. Oh, never mind. y'all are silly. Joey. Now she takes her rope. Oh my god, puppies. Oh. Just salt down. Hey. No, I hit it!
I hit it.
You saw me hit it. Holy fuck.
You think you can be forgiven?
No, no biting. Stop. No biting. Where's your snowman? We can look for it. She has a rope and he wants the rope, so I got the snowman out of the loft. And you can probably hear them.
Time to cut them down.
Get the snowman, Joey. Jeez. Guarding in a slack. Oh, that happened. Okay. Okay, guard, you can work at some point.
I challenge you. Can you see my blade?
Oh, come on. Soul Seed, run away! Well, then I guess I went the complete wrong way. And the bright side is closer to midnight when they get to do everything.
I thought they did away with the military.
Who left this here?
Here's the shipment from Usnan.
You look like a cocoon.
Stasis. Was there a second one here? I can't remember. Guess it was just the one. No, don't want to.
You escaped from Horn.
Run away.
A whole hour has passed already.
I call bullshit on that.
The strangest beasts lurk in the chaos. What hope does the world have?
The fuck is your quest again? Curse Dragon Claw. Okay. So I have to kill that thing in there. Well, that's not happening right now. They got greedy and he just smacked me in the butt. I don't remember where I saw the last treasure chest. Just gonna look up a knot guide. Joey. Oh. Fuck. Joey. Come here. Come here. Come here. Come lay down. Lay down. Good boy. See you trying to get my socks. Watch outside from there.
You, Oh. You make that work.
Hmm.
those horrifying murders.
Chocolina. So where the hell was I? Residences. Oh fuck, I did it again! I keep hitting the left trigger instead of the left bumper. Never happened before.
Can you see my blade?
So I'm gonna have to ask you to stop that at once.
You can't read me. Time to repent.
Rose. Sir, I believe I asked you to stop that. Joey. So that's the first time they aggroed on me. And then he finally got her rope. The fuck is he?
Rumor has it, the victim. I want to see it from my.
Does this have like a fucking timer on it or something? Does it say? Does my not guide say? Eight to five. That's dumb.
I'm home. You look like a cocoon. Is she part of the sanctum?
That's nice and practical.
This broadcast is brought to you by the Public Morals Office of the Order of Salvation. The topic is now PM. Please pray. May the light of the moon dispel the chaos.
Tell me what to do. And all the way back there. And I just missed him. I got it. And boop! Aw.
A great number of our residents have let us offer prayers.
I am nowhere where I need to be. Oh, damn it.
Tears for sale.
Hello? Would you like to buy some tears? I can make you a great deal. I swear you won't regret it.
You're selling your tears? That's not something you see every day.
That's right. People say my tears are beautiful and majestic. They can't get enough. Some even call them the tears of an angel. Would you like to see? Never mind. I guess I can't sell them to you.
But you've already taken my money.
Don't dwell on the money. It's not about that. I can't sell my tears to just anybody, you know.
I've never met a merchant who was bold enough to choose their customers.
I know, but I'm special. I can't give you a refund, but instead you can ask me anything you want. Anything at all.
Nothing. I'd rather not.
Then what if I tell you a story that'll make you want to ask me something? You see, I used to be an actress. This was a long time ago. But then, one day, that thing happened. and I had to quit.
That thing happened.
I can't do much, but I can cry on cue. That's what prompted me to start this business. Come on. Aren't you even the teeniest bit curious why I quit acting? Hmm?
Not really, but I'll listen if you want me to.
Reverse psychology, huh? I'm not falling for that. Besides, I already gave you your money's worth. And that's all for today. If you want
what a
more,
bitch.
Come back another time.
What a bitch. What are these people like? Oh, you want to know why I quit? I'm not going to tell you. Oh, you want to know why? I'm not going to tell you. Come back later.
Citizens, lend me your
oh my
ear.
God. I'm gonna smack me some bitches.
Step right up. Thanks as always.
So fucking stupid.
The Shadow Hunter was a man who once turned.
Wait till you get a taste of these.
Not go that way.
The hunter is back, is he?
When the final bell
there'll be bounty hunters in here.
Doggo! I need the doggo. Bitch!
Lightning strikes.
Oops. Didn't mean I should do that. I should not have my finger up there. Down there. Meow meow. I missed. That's button one. I missed the pole. I always miss the pole when they want to slide down the pole. You make that work. I still can't do this one. Ah. Thank you for the follow. How are you?
Come in.
Blessed be, friend. What can
Aha. Oh, so when it has that those arrows, it's at it max? Yes. Okay, well, how do I level this shit up, actually, then? But it's not yellow. Urgh, whatever.
Thank you for your interest. You look like a cool soldier.
Don't mind me, I'm just gonna slash this really dangerously close to your face.
I couldn't lose.
Yes, run in two completely different directions if you're mother and son. That's safe.
That's nice and practical.
You look like a cocoon soldier. Is that the cocoon style?
Okay, so how late does it need to be for the ghosties? Fucking trigger again.
You got in my way.
Anybody seen any spoopy ghosts? Anybody seen any spoopy ghosts?
Miss Mighty Savior.
Aww. Need 5 more fangs. I need a lot more of these. Like, where? I don't know why I'm all like, it must be in the north side of town.
It's
No, go on. Go on. Tell me more. Nobody wants to tell me anything. I like how everybody, like a lot of people are like super spooked about ghosts and like everybody is out at night. Everybody. Y'all are spooked. Why are you out at night? This makes no sense.
He's been acting strange even for him. He'll randomly burst out laughing as if remembering an old joke or memory. He just doesn't look like he's enjoying himself though.
The cape makes the outfit. I'm home.
Time for the chaos to come.
I'm home.
Reminds me of the Legend of Lucy.
Yes, little girl, you should go home. That's okay. Did you splat your face? Did you trip over nothing? You just got up and you splat your face again. Child, are you okay? Oh my god. He's like taking two steps and falling over. This child has issues. Hold my hand. Hold. Okay, that time I kind of tripped you? Child, are you okay? Holy shit, he's not tripping. It's a miracle! He can actually run! Oh, never mind. I said something. Come on, get up! Come on! Let's see how many steps you take this time. Come on! That's a wall. That's okay. You fell down the stairs. This child. Leave him alone now. Can I sleep? Nope. Oh, hello. I need you.
Nothing I can't handle.
Come on. Three, four, five. Sneezed. Woke up the puppies. There's always been a ladder here. No, I went on the wall. Oh, that's a doggo. I was like, what?
She can do all sorts of things in that.
Yeah, like fight this monster that's about to eat your face. Quite literally.
hope to win.
I went the wrong way. Yeah, you better run, bitch.
Time to eat.
Wow. Scared shitless runs away and is like, oh, it's time to eat. Why would you even have a fucking a meow? It's late at night. People complain about ghosts, and there's still no fucking ghosts. What the shit? Oh right, this is the Carby girl. I did it again. God damn it. Catboy. Why won't you let me talk to you, Catboy?
The residences is filling up with outsiders.
That's nice and bright.
Blaze of lightning.
This is the hey, wait!
Long ago, one woman fought.
I have. 2 hours. Two hours.
Things have taken a turn for the worse around here.
Someone stole my purse!
Well, that sucks. I'm not helping you.
I thought they did away with the military.
I didn't need this dude. I was just escape. That was very much like to finish that one. Pardon me.
But that still won't stop the chaos.
Oh, great.
Sure is on the rise around here. Will you be taking a room? We are.
Oops.
Always, will you be taking a room?
Yes. I forget that inns exist in this game. Time. I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna fuck. Okay. No, it's fine. I saved it. Yay! Got it. I missed.
Nothing I can handle.
Oh, there they go. Careful, Rose. Go, 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 go. That was a wall.
What the hell do you mean?
There they still go. You annoying thing. I need you.
Thank you.
Oh, okay. I thought I blocked that, I guess not. Can you leave my socks alone, please? Here we go.
You. What's going on here?
I've seen her around. You don't want to mess with the likes of her. Run!
You must be Louise. I've come to take you home.
But who are you? Wait. You're the nice lady on the phone, aren't you? I recognize your voice.
That's right. Finally we meet.
Thank you for coming to save me. Even after tricking you all those times. I feel bad about what I did. Really. I mean, all those calls before, they were just pranks.
It's not a prank anymore when you find yourself in real danger. Being kidnapped is serious. Do you realize you would have been killed if I hadn't shown up?
To tell the truth, and don't get mad, I let myself get caught. I told the disciples I volunteer as tonight's sacrifice for the goddess.
What? Why on earth would you do something like that?
Oh, this is hard to explain. Okay, I know this is going to sound a little crazy, but just try and hear me out until the end. Please? The fact is, I lost faith a long time ago. This world has no future. We've waited for hundreds of years for God or the Savior, and neither has shown up. No one knows if there's a tomorrow. Everyone just lives for themselves. No one cares about anything or anyone. So I had to find out if there was still hope.
What do you mean?
It was a bet, okay? I put it all on the line to see if people were really worth believing in anymore. I've pulled my share of pranks and caused trouble, and I've learned that most people will put up with your tricks a couple of times. But no matter how good I act, how much I cry, and how much I beg, no one ever trusts me the third time around. Even I know when to quit, so I made a bet.
Let me get this straight. You purposefully set me up twice and bet your life on me and my morals. Wagering I'd go against your expectations. You were betting on me to answer your third call.
If you did, then I'd be able to keep holding on to hope. I'd want to keep on living.
That's ridiculous. Do you even understand how lucky you are to be alive? You wouldn't be standing here talking to me if I hadn't made it in time.
I knew you'd come and save me, though. Don't ask me how, but I knew that you were a good person.
What made you think that? You don't know me at all.
I know. I just believed in you somehow. Maybe because I wanted to. I wanted to believe there was still hope in this dying world. And look what happened.
Hey.
You came through for me. Just like I knew.
Rose.
All of a sudden I feel like a pawn in your game. And you're the one playing both sides.
That was silly. Well, maybe a little. But I'm trying to thank you. I'm glad there are still people like you in the world. You inspire me to keep my faith in humanity.
In that case, you're welcome, I guess. I'm glad to hear that all that running around was worth something. Remember, your life is valuable. Don't ever forget that.
I hope y'all don't have a sock down there.
And I'll never do anything like this ever again. Thank you.
I'ma smack this bitch. Oh, that's what you have. You have the ducky thing. Okay, that's fine. He's not gonna get it, Rosie. Okay. Just that guy cheering me on.
I need you.
Don't get in my way. I challenge you. You think you can be forgiven?
I'm sure if dodged or hit.
Time to cut them down.
Yep, I was at that time. I'm hitting the wrong button again. So where is man with no name? Rose, you can't fluff up the carpet. No, but how am I supposed to? Ah!
Oh,
strikes.
Okay. Oh, I just noticed there's a fucking ladder. So fucking blind. I'm like, how the fuck am I supposed to go that way if I can only go there from one way? I'm so dumb. Welcome.
What?
Care to tell me your name?
You only need a name if you want to talk to people. If you don't, then what good is it? That's why I don't need one. Nor do I ever want one again.
He's laughing with his mouth closed.
You're definitely the one I'm looking for. The man without a name.
The fuck That's is you. He wearing?
It's true, I've been nameless for many years. But am I the one you seek? Who knows? Who knows anything for certain in this dying world?
I guess we can skip the introductions then. I've got a question for you. The reason I wanted to talk to you is because I'm looking for a journal. It belonged to Ranulf.
Ranulf's journal? Why? What do you want with a thing like that?
Nothing. It's not for me. He asked me to find it for him. I'm just doing him a favor.
I thought this day would come. After 2 centuries, I'd hoped he'd given up. But when has a man like me ever gotten his way in this miserable world? So much water under the bridge.
What did you say?
You say Ranulf asked you to do this for him. Is that true?
That's right. He did.
Then go to Yusnan. A woman named Durin has what you're looking for. When you see her, hand her this letter. Tell her that Reddick sent you.
Reddick? So that's your name?
It was centuries ago. Anyway, you tell Durin who sent you, and she'll help you out. Durin liked to watch the trains go by. She would sit and watch for hours. You'll probably find her near the overlook in Yusnan, where you can see the tracks.
Listen.
I suppose I should get up.
I just happen to have a bit of history with the shadow.
Surprise.
I've had work.
I'm hitting buttons, you know. Joey, it's okay. It's okay, sweetie. Joey. Oh boy, they love to bark and growl at things. Joey! Come on. Come down. Joey. Come on. Come on. I don't even know what they're barking at. They're just laying here trying to get their puppy nap, but they keep waking up.
Plants and trees so grow and die as they once did, but humans are trapped in the
now. Is it spoopy time? Spoopy? Oops, spoopy. Oh, god damn it, sock. Give me my sock, please. Give me my sock, please. No. 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 That's my sock, little girl. Dan, take your puppy nap. I don't wanna. Adventuring essentials.
I'm surprised you've heard of me. What do you want?
Wow, rude.
Require a room?
Come again, any-
Can I just like... No?
Time. Require a room?
Go to a different place this time. That was a crotch shot. That was trying to be a crotch shot.
Sarah, are you there? Can you hear me?
Yes. Yes, I can hear you. I've been waiting. For such a long time, just to see you. But I'm coming home now. It's been a long journey, and it's almost over. I've got so many things I want to tell you.
Yeah, me too.
Lightning, you're just like I remember. We haven't seen each other for so long, but you won't let on that you're glad.
You're my sister. You know me better than that. Like you always tell me, I don't wear my heart on my sleeve.
Yeah. The number of times Snow and I tried to get you to crack a smile, but we never could. Except for that one time. You've always been like that. Even when we were kids. But Light, when you've done your mission, and I come back, promise me that you'll smile for me then, okay?
Sarah was right. Ever since I could remember, even as a child, I always kept my feelings deep inside. But this time, it wasn't a mask, and I wasn't hiding my joy.
When I saw Sarah, I didn't feel anything at all. It's like whatever love I'd had for her was gone from my heart.
Dun, dun, dun. Lay down, Rosie. Man, I suck at this. Babies.
Once upon a time, Noel was one of the leaders. He helped us in the struggle against the chaos. When the Order took the reins of power, he went underground, but he didn't disappear. He worked from the shadows to help keep the peace.
It was just for a second, but I saw Sarah. I guess I must be doing something right. God decided to give me a little taste of my final reward.
You don't sound very pleased.
Ever since I woke up as the savior, I haven't felt much of anything.
I think it's because you've been made something more than human, something almost divine.
Wait, what do you mean?
The savior is God's chosen servant. The Aradia is your life force now. It's the light of God himself inside every cell of your being. What I'm saying is, it's as if you're turning into a god yourself.
And when does that stop? When the end comes, will I be sitting up there in heaven with Bonavelsa himself? Not the future I want.
So in order to do this one, I have to do this one. Blue jacket at the clock tower. Of course. Meh.
This broadcast is brought to you by the public tutorial process of the Order of Salvation. Please pray and thank Almighty God for allowing us to see another dawn.
Joey. Stop. Damn it. Stop. 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 started to chew at the carpet and pull at it. I don't need another hole in my carpet.
Try to keep up.
God damn it.
Mission accomplished.
Find me.
Reminds me of the legend of the sea.
Trust me, let the professionals handle these things.
But you're not a professional.
A frontal assault will do it. Challenge accepted. Time to mix it up.
Shall we? That I really need to move my fingers every time.
I couldn't lose.
Stop. Stop. Come on, stop. Leave it alone. Stop. Leave it alone. Stop. Stop.
The day is not
tower.
Time to roll up my sleeves.
Amen.
Today, a great number of our let us offer prayer.
It's all true.
I hear rumors of the murder victims' apparitions go against the Order's beliefs.
I remember talking to him.
You said it.
Damn it. Rose! Stop. Sorry. This guy is stuck in the thing. So there's supposed to be like a guy in a blue coat here that I can talk to, but there's not. The other way.
Is it time for the chaos to rend the land and cover the sky?
Progress on that. Oops. Oh, right, I was supposed to. Okay, I can still, I can keep going this way. Bullshit.
Don't even try. Now.
Wait,
is that the cocoon style?
Guys, keep it warm.
Citizens, lend me your ear.
Well, I've checked them all. The supply spheres were clean, every one of them. Not even a hint of anything dangerous.
Yes, actually, I just found out the same thing on my end. Apparently, the whole thing was all just a big joke. Not a very funny one.
Really? Damn it, this isn't the time for pranks.
You're telling me. It was a young girl named Lumina. She's usually lurking around the cathedral. She said the spheres were supposed to be a gift for whoever found them.
I should have guessed.
She also left behind a message. A present from me to you. Good luck saving all our souls. Wait, she thought the savior would find them. Why, that would make you the savior.
If you see
but
her around,
I am.
Tell her thanks for the extra supplies.
The savior.
And that I don't believe in luck.
I'll be sure to tell her that. She likes to have a little fun sometimes, but she means no harm. She knows her boundaries. She knows when enough is enough.
Really? That's hard to believe. That little devil causes trouble everywhere she goes, and everywhere she doesn't.
Now, we all need to give her a break. After all, these are trying times, and we all need to let off a little steam sometimes. She helps us laugh a little, and lightens the mood for all of us.
Did I just get a mustache? Wow. Look, that's like is spinning out of my butt. Wow. I have a mustache. Look at my mustache. That's funny.
Rumor has it, the victims, the children. I want to see it for myself.
I'm just like not gonna touch that for now until I fucking figure it out. I see you, Marshmallow Man. And I'm a boopy. Just gotta go down here. Okay.
The souls of disbelievers will sink into the chaos and will be ravished
by the goddess of death. I can read maps.
Are you a tourist? I am here to help guide visitors to the sites. Is there any place you'd like to know about? Come visit anytime.
This is Luxarian's very own. The trains here can take you to either of two locations. The Wildlands is a vast expanse in the Dead Dunes. You won't, however, many venture out there in hopes of finding. If you're looking to travel to, please head to Luxarian's. Are you taking the train?
No, I want to read.
So this is the last surviving wilderness.
Chocobo.
It's the world as it once was. Nature's last stand. Wild beasts still live and die here as they always have. It's raw in nature, red in tooth and claw, and the chaos here is just as dangerous. The people who live out here are not like the city dwellers. They're different. They don't follow the teachings of the Order. And they don't want to rely on handouts either. so they strive to live off the land.
Shippies! Ah!
A refuge for those who refuse to be tamed. Is that it?
Light!
The encounter is ordained. You have been led to the fountainhead whence the chaos flows. Here you will meet the servant of fate, adorned with feathers of white. The angel of Valhalla.
Light? What just happened?
I heard a voice. It said that I've been led here, and I'm supposed to meet someone. The angel of Valhalla.
What kind of voice? I didn't pick anything up on this end.
A young girl, but I don't think she's close. It was more like she was speaking from the chaos itself.
I just ran a search on this angel person, but it came up blank. Maybe you should ask the locals.
Lightning, that's you. Oh hey, I can teleport now. I know how to use markers.
Yeah? What do you want?
I have a question for you. Have you ever heard of someone called the Angel of Valhalla?
You must be new to these parts. There's not a man or woman here that doesn't know the Angel.
The Angel of Valhalla isn't a person. It's a legendary chocobo, covered in feathers as white as the clouds. It's the sacred bird that only appears at the end of the world.
So it's a local legend, then?
Yeah, a legend. At least that's what it used to be. But in recent times, many folk have seen the bird with their own two eyes. A lot of us are thinking maybe that story is true.
Maybe it is, but Dr. Ghazal has been after it for years, and he still doesn't have proof that the beast is the one from legend.
Dr. Ghazal? Who would that be?
The famous veterinarian, of course. A prickly character with the temper of a behemoth, but he loves his chocobos. When it comes to the angel, he's the leading expert in all of the wildlands.
The doctor lives up the road a bit, in the village of Canopus Farms. If you catch him in a good mood, he'll help you out. Maybe.
A white chocobo at the end of the world.
There's nothing about this in any of the official scriptures of the Order. It's a local story. A super-
Chocobo Colina!
Accept everything! Do all the things!
Even if it is, someone spoke to me. The voice was real, and it mentioned the Angel of Valhalla. I want to know who it was.
If you think that's what you need to do, then go ahead. You have a lead, at least.
Right, I bet.
You aren't from around here, are you? I suppose you've come to seek the wisdom of our famous Dr. Ghazal.
I wanted to ask him about the Angel of Valhalla.
I knew it. Well, first things first. You have heard of our chocobo legend, right?
You mean the one about a sacred white chocobo that appears at the end of the world?
That's the one. Some of us call that chocobo the Angel of Salvation. Oh, how we've been praying for him to appear. The angel is a harbinger, a signal that it's over at last.
That's something to pray for?
Oh, yes. For the people who live out here, death is a kind of salvation. An outsider like you must find it difficult to understand. 5 centuries ago, all hell broke loose and a new god took over.
We became immortal, against all natural laws. See, the people out here don't like that. Even gods shouldn't be allowed to change the natural order of things. Living off the land, growing our own food, surviving by our own wits, and dying when our time is up. That's what we want. And that's why the white chocobo is a good thing. It means this unnatural life is going to be over at last. Right? But you're welcome to believe different. We don't push our creed on anyone. At the same time, as long as you're going to be visiting us here for a while, it's right that you know our ways.
For the people of the Wildlands, the white chocobo is a sign. A herald of a special kind of salvation. Many of these lands worship Etro, the goddess of death. They pray to eventually return to her side, which in their creed is the same as ceasing to exist.
Don't get in my way. Mission accomplished.
Something?
By all accounts, he's a difficult man to deal with.
The vegetables they grow make perfect fodder for the chocobos.
Hello there, stranger. Welcome to Canopus Farms. My name's Garrett. Guess you could say I run things around here. What can we do for you?
I've come to talk to your vet, Dr. Ghazal.
Ah, got it. You want to know about the Angel of Valhalla, right? Well, Dr. Ghazal's your man.
Yeah, well, that's what everyone tells me.
He's been chasing that white chocobo for over a century now. No one comes close to his passion and expertise. It's all he cares about since his daughter died.
What is it?
Ah, oh, damn. I shouldn't have said anything about his daughter. It's not a secret or anything, but he really hates anybody talking about it. The doctor first came out here with his daughter. They planned to learn about the legend together. But about a century ago, she was killed while they were both out tracking chocobos. It was tragic. The doctor never really told the whole story of what happened. But after that, he threw himself even deeper into his research and work. Soon, it was all he cared about. But listen, promise me one thing, okay?
I won't let on that you told me. Don't worry.
Thanks. I'd appreciate it. I mean, everyone around these parts knows the story, of course. But he wouldn't like it if strangers started asking about his past. Anyway, if you're interested in seeing the legendary chocobo for yourself, Dr. Ghazal is the man you have to talk to. They say he's seen the Angel of Valhalla more than a few times. At least a chocobo that looks just like it.
Sounds like he could help.
I bet my hunting bow on it. Well, may nature bless you.
What do you mean?
It's just a saying we have out here in the wildlands. It means good luck.
The stories of the mythic.
Excuse me, do you know anything about the Angel of Valhalla?
Do I? You're as smart as you look coming to me with that question. I'll have you know I'm the oldest. Yes, that's right. The oldest surviving student of the great Dr. Ghazal himself. First, the basics. The legendary chocobo, the so-called
surviving
Angel of Valhalla,
student.
Is not a creature anyone can find just by looking for it.
Except, I'm guessing you're gonna tell me that you can.
Not quite, but I can tell you what the good doctor has told me. That angel is anything but angelic. It's a rough, wild beast. He deliberately seeks out his mortal foe, the chocobo eater. So you see, if you wish to find the white chocobo of legend...
I should find a chocobo eater.
Precisely. I knew you were smart. Now, the last sighting of a chocobo eater was in the City of Ruins. The ruins lie in grim terrain that stretches yonder to the east. But the chocobo eater is a fearsome beast. Be prepared for a fight.
If you want to find the prey, seek out the predator. It makes sense.
Hey, don't step on the vegetables.
Sorry, I didn't mean to.
It's all right. No harm done. I was only warning you. I've just planted a whole crop of Ghazal seedlings.
Right. Chocobo's favorite food.
Yep.
and our bread and butter. My name is Sirala, by the way. This is our field. My father's and mine. We've always worked it together. Nice to meet you and everything.
You should head east and find the city of ruins.
Merchant! Do you sell stuff?
I purchase fresh vegetables while I'm here.
Hey, Potion! Just gonna sell some of these.
Encounter is ordained. You have been led to the fountainhead whence the chaos flows. Does that mean anything to you?
Great Etros Helm. Where did you hear those words? Who spoke them?
A young girl, but I never saw her.
A maiden's voice born on the wind. Yes. Yes, that's how I heard them too. So it would appear that she has spoken to both of us. Very well. I will share what I know. The angel is a tempestuous chocobo that lives in these plains. I myself have glimpsed the creature many times, but unfortunately have never succeeded in capturing him. It is said whoever can break him and ride him will become his master. But I've long since given up hope that it shall be me.
Nor me. I don't know anything about chocobos.
Don't rule yourself out, young lady. You may be the one. If you're telling the truth about the voice, that is. It's true, not everyone who hears the voice is the chosen one. But rest assured, the encounter will happen. The legends tell us that the chocobo's chosen master will be led by the chocobo to a certain place. I speak of that dread edifice whence the chaos emerges, the temple of Etro herself.
You mean the one built into the cliff?
The very same. And deep below that sinister haven of destruction, an ocean of chaos roils, the great chaos of the stories.
What does that mean? Is it a different kind of chaos?
Alas, the legends give us few details. If you wish to find an answer to that question, you will have to seek the truth in the temple.
And to do that, I've got to find and tame the Angel of Valhalla.
Yes, indeed. But that, let me assure you, is no easy task. I have a couple of assistants who live here in the village. Talk to them, and they can give you advice about finding the chocobo.
An ocean of great chaos buried beneath a temple.
Chocobo.
Do you think it could be true? Does the Order know anything about it?
No. I'd say it's likely they don't.
Hi. What do you need today?
Hey, I would like to get some glamour, please. Oh, that's... okay. Oh my! I'm just like buying everything. All elements.
Safe travels.
I should get ready for work. That's not the button I wanted. Maybe I'll stream more later. Poof. And getting ready for work. And I should help somebody. Poof.